sorry about that, but the previous band couldn't make it today. They had some very important function somewhere or the other. So that was it. Anyhow, look, ladies and gentlemen, we have been requested to just enlarge upon that previous little episode because, as you know, this is a very succinct bit of history. So, now that's better. Excuse me. 1, 2, 3, 4. Excuse me, ladies and gentlemen, we have been requested to enlarge upon the previous cadenza. So here we go from the top. Is that all right, Cyril? Cyril, are you there? Extra feed? Yeah, absolutely. Get on with it, Mr. Aaron, will you? Damn you. Okay. Yes, okay. Right, I'm getting warmed up now. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, B, A, boo, 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 boo. Here we are. Okay, I'm ready, willing, and able, I hope. Incidentally, ladies and gentlemen, and others, of course, from the press. Where the hell do they all come from? Recently, frightfully expensive, even dodgy research has revealed unequivocally that Miss Salome, or not to be, that is the something or other, was in fact a hale and hearty 87 and a half years old at this auspicious theatrical occasion in the Middle East somewhere or other. Blowflies and sand and camels by the thousands in this period of history. The point is that Miss Salome, at this time, this auspicious occasion, as you remember and have read repeatedly, was, this is it, she was well past the pension eligibility stipulation. In fact, she was previously 87 and a half years old, and not the 3.5 twinkle-toed years as previously hoped for, expected. Hoped for? Really? Is that true? Astonishing, but Jesus. But the point is, you must remember, they all say that. All actresses and even actors, they take 40 years off their true age of enlightenment. However, cherubs and others, of course, this succinct information puts a distinctly different complexion, well, black and blue and a tinge of yellow, silver spots, and a dash of you know what, okay? I mean, it puts a different slant on this situation. For those without their rosettes, the thesaurus well thumbed, and the Divine Comedy, page 11,042. Where are we? So it puts a different slant on this curious and curiouser tale of, how could we say, domestic bliss with a vengeance. So there, okay, I'm going to stop there, sir. You will be very tickled, Pink, to know that our Miss, still, absolutely, you know who, has taken up with the one-note vuvuzela, the no-note didgeridoo, and absolutely nothing coming out of the bagpipe. A gazoo, not a gazoo, but a kazoo. Or two, showing great promise in all of them. In fact, the Albert Hall is next week. She's got to play all of these things, of course. And there is a television film of her unique talents and, listen, a lucrative, extremely lucrative endorsement of a host of products. Washing powder, soap, hair rinse, and her fashions, listen to this. Naturally, her fashions include a little item called putting on seven dresses. Putting on seven dresses rather than taking them off. Now, isn't that cute? And flinging the rest to the gasping crowd, etc. She suggests that, now listen, this is financial acumen of the ultimate in financial acumen. You pay for seven, but you only get one. Now, isn't that funny? Isn't that cute? Isn't it just like Salome? It's one of her little clever little dodges. So didn't she do well, our little prodigy? Well. So anyhow, I think I should sing that song again to remind you of this absolutely acute thing. This was from Act 2, Scene 3 of the very famous Australian opera called On the Outback and Beyond. And it goes like this, Salome. Oh, Salome, Salome, you should see her dance. Standing there with a neurobot and every little wriggle, if she can still wriggle, she can certainly wriggle, makes the boys all stare through their drunken, bleary eyes. I mean, you would, wouldn't you, mate? So, there's another little stop press. There have been numerous bookings for a repeat of her famous Seven Veils. In a kilt and a grass skirt, beg your pardon. I mean, it's got a bit of a scoot there. And a bin liner. Listen, bin liner. The Dance of the Seven Veils using a bin liner, which is, of course, biodegradable, however you say that. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you like that. I think we have the end of this story. I don't want to hear either do you. Good afternoon.
Damn it. Can't find my damn didgeridoo. This will have to do. Anyhow, this will have to do. Is that all right, Cyril? Cyril? Well, that's all right, Cyril. Come find my didgeridoo. Have you got it? Here we go. Here we go. Than a didgeridoo. Right, Cyril?